Hello everyone, I'm Ryan211, and today I'm redoing my video on how to install Payday 2 mods. There's quite a few videos on this out there, but most of them are quite flawed. Miles 1, for example, had sound issues and way too much rambling. So first of all, let's find the game folder. Usually it will be on system drive, then program files x86, go to Steam, Steam apps, common, and then here Payday 2 would be. Except I have it on a different drive. Alternatively, you go to Steam, then Library, then you right-click Payday 2 and select Properties, and then Local Files, and then Browse, and that would also open the game folder. In here, I will first explain the most simple type of mods. Those would go in the Mod Overrides folder. This folder isn't there by default, so you might have to create it. And in here, simple mods go like retextures, model replacements, or simple sound placements. The game recognizes this folder and loads mods from there by default, so you don't need any extra requirements. Some mods go in there which do have requirements, so they wouldn't load by default if you just put them in there and installed nothing else, but I will explain that later. So, let's get an example here. This is a mod I made, very funny, body pillow mod. And if I were to download it, I'd just get this. It's a RAR file, or it might be a zip file. So you need WinRAR, WinZip, 7-zip, that kind of software. It is slided in here, and you're done. You can recognize these simple mods by their tags and their description. And it doesn't list any requirements. And it also says, obviously, mod overrides, so it has to go in that folder I showed you. For the more complex mods, you need SuperBLT. SuperBLT handles the code mods for Payday 2. Again, you need archiving software to download the file, and then you just put the DLL file in the game folder here. Once you then run the game once, it will create the mods folder, and in here, you put your code mod. It will state that obviously, usually. It also has this requirement, Visual Studio 2017. It's usually already installed since it's a common game requirement, but better just make sure and download it anyway. So let's get another mod from me, Dreadnought Bag. And if I were to download this, it here shows Lua, maybe it says requires SuperBLT or requires BeardLib, and those, SuperBLT would just download it. Any other requirements you can just Google, and then you get this. So, very simple. Again, you just drag it in. It's also very recognizable. If the mod has a mod.txt, it always goes in the mod folder. Main.xml is from BeardLib, I believe, handles my auto-updating of this mod. I forgot I had that. So this file works in both folders, but this one only works in the mods folder. So if this file is in the mod, you know the folder goes in the mods folder. If it isn't there, it basically always has to go in the mod overrides folder. So now that we have this more complex mod installed, there's only one thing I might like to mention, which is that if it says requires BeardLib, you simply search it, and here it is. It's a very common requirement for music mods, custom weapons, custom skins, that kind of stuff. So that's easy to find. You just install it like a normal mod, and then you're done. I hope this video was more useful than the old one, and if so, leave a like, maybe subscribe, and maybe I will make more of this kind of content.